Tonight, a call free consumer investigation. Sushi bars are as trendy as coffee shops these days. You can find one just about anywhere. But are they really serving what you ordered?
Or are they duping consumers to increase their profits by using a less expensive fish in place of the one on the menu? Call 3's Lindsay Paulo took a hidden camera and went fishing for answers.
Americans are hooked on sushi.
All of the flavors, the spices, the combination of the fish with the vegetables, I think it's terrific.
I like it because it's fresh, it's healthy, it fills you up, but not too much.
But is the sushi you're eating really what you think it is? Sushi bars across the country are committing sushi substitution. Farion International, a DNA testing laboratory in New York, has documented repeatedly restaurants using lower quality, less expensive fish for the real thing on the menu.
About 50% of the fish that we've tested are not of the species that they're supposed to be.
We hired Farion to do DNA testing in our area. Using a hidden camera, we went to 8 sushi restaurants from Davis to downtown Sacramento to Roseville and Rockland. We ordered red snapper. The traditional Japanese name is Thai. It's overfished and harder to find, making it more expensive than other fish. The Food and Drug Administration says it's commonly substituted by a less expensive fish.
Oh my goodness, that's kind of scary.
We brought our sushi back to KCRA, followed Therion's instructions for extracting samples, and shipped it for DNA testing. Therion found of our 8 samples, 6 were tilapia, 1 was white bass. Only 1 actually was red snapper.
It has to be a knowing substitution along the way, whether it's the importer, the distributor, the restaurant chain, or the restaurant itself that's doing it. I don't know. But it's basically, it's deliberate.
We went back to the 8 restaurants to ask the owners about the sushi substitution. None would talk with us on camera, but several did talk with us off camera. Some told us there are different names for red snapper, and because red snapper and tilapia are the same kinds of fish from different regions, it's substituting from the same family. Diners wait up to an hour or more outside Fuji Chef in Davis to fill up on the all-you-can-eat buffet. When we asked about their tilapia, the manager told us they order red snapper, but the distributor may give them tilapia. At Daruma in West Sacramento, the owner insisted he served red snapper and even offered to show us the package. But right on the frozen fish, it said tilapia. He promised to change the menu to reflect that. The only restaurant which served us the real thing, Mikuni in downtown Sacramento. Mikuni gave us red sea bream, which is authentic Japanese red snapper, a high-end fish. Taro Arai owns Mikuni Restaurants.
I think each restaurant owner believes in their way, and I have to respect their way. But my way is, I don't want to downgrade the fish. I want customers to have the best we can have. And we might have to ask them to pay a little bit more, but they'll get the right fish.
Arai says tilapia costs just more than a buck a pound. Red snapper from New Zealand, $6 a pound. And the sea bream Mikuni uses from Japan runs $16 a pound. Therion believes cost drives species substitution.
It is not any way, shape, or form a correct substitution, and it's certainly illegal by any standards, whether it be FDA or, you know, state regulations, et cetera, et cetera.
But we learned there really isn't any state regulation for species substitution. No state department or agency we called claims jurisdiction over the problem. And while the FDA says it is aware of it, it does not have the resources to police it. In Sacramento, Lindsay Paulo, KCRA 3 reports.
Farion International says a consumer's best protection is only ordering high-end fish in the higher-end restaurants. Now, the FDA does investigate some claims of species substitution, but really focuses its limited resources on food safety.